On Monday, the Clerk to Parliament, Adolf Mwesige, issued a notice recalling all members of Parliament from Christmas holiday to fasten the process of Namganza censure motion. The order paper that was released yesterday headlined the Namganza censure motion, among other few items on the agenda.
The order paper also talks of a select committee that's supposed to be appointed by Parliament to look into the issues of censorship of Honorable Minister Namganza. This is to give a fair hearing on both parties, which I think is really called for. By the time the censorship takes shape on, they will have heard from both sides.
However, today an amendment of the Friday's order paper has been released suddenly by Parliament, with only 5 items excluding the matter to constitute the select committee to consider the resolution of Parliament to censure Namganza, which was item number 3 on the order paper. This left some MPs questioning the motive.
Students say that the censure of Honorable Namganza is sensational. There are so many issues which have come to Parliament, and the Speaker has the powers to alternate the order paper or change the order paper. Maybe there are some very urgent issues which came after that necessitated the changing of the order paper.
But there are so many other things that can be handled. So Namganza issues will come later. It's not that the executive has boxed out whether it is the issue of the executive. The Parliament is independent, though at times you may think that the executive intervenes with the operations of Parliament. But let us concentrate on issues that are productive to this country and service delivery at large.
A few things that as a Parliament we can look at.
Some people assume the sudden amendment of the order paper was prompted by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament Thomas Taiwa's absence in the country. Yet the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among is perceived as an interested party in the matter who may not chair proceedings in the House.
Party needs party cohesion, and I feel changing of the order paper, if it is not only delaying, but I feel it should be in good faith, we should fight to make sure that there are other serious issues that are bedeviling Ugandans much more than censoring a minister.
There is another school of thought that the 14 days period which are provided to the Speaker by the Parliamentary Rules of Procedure to appoint a select committee have not matured from the date the motion of censure was transmitted to the President. But some legislators believe the Namganza motion can still surface on Friday because the Speaker has powers to amend the order paper.
When you are seated in a plenary, she can amend it. So if you assume that Namganza who are supposed to be on the order paper, she's not there, it can be amended.
As the House resumes, MPs have urged the administration of Parliament to give priority to issues affecting the common people which they have gathered from the constituencies during the Christmas break instead of highlighting the censure motion.
Parliament, as we begin the season, first of all, prices of common commodities, we need to look through on how the budget for next financial year 2023-2024 can be a budget that captures service delivery.
You remember, government is focusing on parish development model. We want to focus more on ensuring that our people earn income enhancement in the communities.
Namganza was guilty of contempt of Parliament and gross misbehavior and recommended her censure. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.